You're just a decent fish, huh? Brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, best rods on earth. Strike King Lure Company, number one in fishing lures. Ardent, rule the water. Go on there. Extreme Angler TV, first thing in the morning with a brand new bait and a brand new summer on top, KVD Splash. Strike King looks like the little Spitting King, but it's a little bit different features. We're going to show you today, hopefully the smallmouth like it just as much as I do. We're going to throw it, work it, catch it, have some fun. Let's see. Here's something to consider. When you're throwing topwater in the morning, you got to be aware. You know, you're focused on where you're throwing, different depths, you know, back on history and areas that you've caught fish on, but pay attention. Seagulls, loons, anything that's feeding, or fish that are surfacing, boiling, etc., go to the feeding fish. You're going to catch them first thing. Pay attention, focus on what you're doing, but pay attention in the area for feeding fish. Yeah, that's a big one right there. Let's put it right back in there, see what happens. Ready? Seem to be more out in this open water. Oh, see that? Like kissing it. Wow. There he goes. And not bad either. Oh, they're in a slow mood. You can just tell by that kind of bite, huh? Slow mood. They just want to kiss it. I got a small bait on too. You think they'd be unintimidated by it. Some days they want it fast, loud, and big. Some days, like this, small. He's just a little shaker as well. Hold on. You're just a shaker, huh? It is so imperative to let the fish tell you how they want it. You know, it's summertime, the water's 8 degrees, and you think it'd be boom, boom, boom. And it can be. These fish, I see the mayflies, see how fat their bellies are? They're like in a lazy zombie mode. They just want it sitting there. They just come up and roll on it, pull it down, just like a fly or something else they're eating. Lazy. The bellies are full. They don't want to exert a lot of energy. Not a bad one either. Oh, I'd say. I guess I made the right choice, huh? Whoa, look at them surge, huh? Just back off that little ardent right there. Let them pull. Whoa, that's fun. Whoa, they ever got power, man. I tell you, I love the brown bass. Look at them go. Jeez. You want to take somebody fishing the first time? Take it for topwater smallmouth. I guarantee they'll be hooked for life. Look at this thing. You know? Look at him. He's not even a big fish. But man, tough. Tough, tough. Look where he got it too. Underneath the jaw. He was so nuts on it. Look at it. He got it underneath the jaw. Underneath. Take it out. That's what you get right there. Warm summertime smallmouth. He's not a real big fish, but boy, when they're biting my bait, like that new little KVD Splash, and you see what I got on there? Little cross lock. Gives it a bit more action. I don't have to do much rod twitching or line moving, all that kind of stuff. Just give it a little twitch. It does all the rest. It calls up them smallmouth. Let's see if we can get one of those big ones to come up. So I just gotta slow down. Put it out there. As soon as it lands, they know it's there. Just small twitches. Get it close to the boat. Satisfied. Bring it in. Cast out. Another spot. Keep looking for aggressive fish. There's a showstopper. Look at him. Man, oh man, are they like a zombo mood or what? Well, I think he was made for TV, huh? That's a nice jump. I give you the best of me. You know what? They are feeding because they're fat, real fat. I think they're eating mayflies. Mayfly. But they're not jumping too crazy, exuding all their energy. The bellies are, look at that. Look how fat that is. Look what's on the surface here. Those are all mayflies. I know you boys are eating good now, aren't you? Sometimes when they're eating mayflies, the bite can be a little slow, but you still just gotta figure it out. Drop shot, stick worm, twitch bait, whatever. Go by whatever, you know, triggering effect. But morning topwater, hard to beat it, man. It's a lot of fun. But I need a big one. Let's go get one. You know, if you're in a good little spot and you stop getting bit, work the area deeper, shallower, slower, faster. Try to figure them out. You stop catching them, move. You know, it's just a soft, soft bite. I mean, almost every fish is right here, 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 underneath here, whatever, right on there. That shows you these fish are not aggressive. They still want to eat. They're smallmouth bass. Their instinct is to eat. Even their bellies are like, ugh. They see it, they still want it. You got to present it in the right way, slow, fast, whatever it takes. You got to do it to keep catching. Fish just ate right there. Let's see if I can catch that fish. Look at this right here, chasing. Boy, oh boy. They're eating flies, man. Eating the flies. Oh, good one. Wow. See that one? Holy cow. Wow. I'd say, let's see if he stays hooked. Whoa. Let it sit. He finds it and tail walks. Wow. You just take your time. Let him pull. Let him pull, not drag. Wow. He's gonna maybe come up again. He's got too much of a fat belly on him. Look how tough. It's like those first ones. Tough, tough fish. Look at them. Wow. He came out of the water. I swear he was a giant, huh? Look at that. Because I think he's got it right underneath. Yeah. You got it underneath there, didn't you? Now you're net full, aren't you? You're actually better than I thought you were. Look at that. Just beautiful. Again, look at the bellies. Almost look like they're fall fish. I mean, I'm gonna let you go. Ready? Go on. Keep moving. Okay, what I'm seeing now is two things I gotta do. Move fast, fish slow. Find fish that wanna eat, move around a little bit. That's the keys. You start pinpointing the things to catch fish when you're out there, patterning, putting your presentation together, the right baits. So what I'm gonna do now, keep moving on with a trolling motor. If I see fish moving, if I see bait fish moving, stay in that about 4 to 7 foot level, or maybe there's feeding fish, but move, cast, work the bait slow, but mostly when it lands, the first cast, I know if there's a fish there, because he just got him. Let's go. Now, what do you think it is that triggers those fish to become really aggressive and then almost dormant? What is it? Is it feeding habits, time of the day? Just they've had enough. But out here, it's a big flat. And just like somebody said, turn the switch off, stop biting, eat later, make them wait it out. Cottage Angler, tips and tactics to make you a better fisherman.
Hi, I'm James Niggemeyer, and I compete on the Bassmaster Elite Series Tournament Trail, as well as have a guide service on Lake Fork. You know, I get a lot of people that ask me, there's so many rods and so many techniques, and how many rods do I need to buy, and how much is it going to cost if I get reels for each one and line, and it can be kind of overwhelming. And you go to a tackle store, and you look around, and it can be a lot to take in. And as a guy just coming in, or a guy on a budget, you could really get away with three different rods. In my opinion, the one that you probably need the most, and I would consider that the number one purchase, like a 7 foot, either a 6'6" or a 7 foot medium heavy rod. Because with this, you could throw a spinnerbait, you could throw a jig, you could throw a worm, you could throw a topwater lure, you can throw different baits like that, a buzz bait, and get away with a lot of different things. So this is a real multi-purpose rod. You know, if I want to throw crankbaits, anything with a treble hook, red-eye shads, square bills, like a KVD 1.5, I would consider a glass rod, like a Mojo Bass. Either their 7'4" cranker or their Mojo Bass target cranker. And this way I can throw my crankbaits and all my treble hook baits, and I can hook and land more fish because you've got that parabolic action of a glass blank with these St. Croix rods. So you've got those two different rods to kind of handle both sides of that. The last thing I think a guy would need for finesse fishing, tubes, drop shots, shaky heads, a good 6'6" to 7 foot medium action spinning rod. So you can use all your light 6 to 10 pound test fluorocarbons and handle all the light finesse style tactics, wacky worms, all those types of things. And this way you could cover everything. You could really throw your crankbaits, you could throw your jigs and your Texas rig worms, and you can throw your light finesse style tactics. So with those three rods, I think you could definitely get by and be really effective on the water any given day, anywhere in the country.
Cover water, put it out there, way up there. Find those aggressive fish. Let it land, small twitch. Guarantee you, anywhere from 2 feet to 20 feet, they're in that water column. They're not all on the bottom, not on the top, in the middle, they're all over the place. When they're feeding, they're feeding. They know when that lands. They know everything in their environment. So when I put it out there, you know, when it's slick calm like this, they know it's there. You don't have to just put tons of action in it and stuff. Just let it sit, twitch it a few times. If you get nothing, bring it in, try a new spot. Keep moving. And what I do sometimes when I'm moving towards an area that I want to fish, I'll fish to my left, right, cover all kinds of the water column in the depth you're, you know, going to maybe a waypoint or a place you caught them before. Just cover that whole water column, you know, not just in a straight line, keep your focus ahead, but left, right, you catch way more fish by covering a good area by sweeping through. Oh boy, oh boy. I just finished saying, huh? They're not too far, are they? Whoa, whoa, whoa. Right off the side of the weeds. I think it's a decent one. Look at them banging a boat. Wow. Smallmouth or something else, aren't they? Look at them, just a nice chunky fish. Look where he was too, hey? Yep, in those weeds. Look at that. Just a gorgeous example of Ontario smallmouth bass. I can't tell you how much fun this is. Look how fat they are. That's what makes them so much fun. They feel that weight. They got the power, eh? Short and stocky, look at them. Whoa, they're not like long and lean, like Silva the spider. These things are short and stocky. Unbelievable, man. Gonna keep moving. My day is almost done. Find some weeds, slow it down, find a fish that wants to eat. That was the key. Keep moving. Quick, fish slow. slow to go. Let him see it. Twitch it a few times. Let it sit. But those fish that come up and eat it, as soon as it lands, they're like gold, really. Because you know you put it right where he is. Whoa! They turn, they come up, pull it down. No big smashing bites, you know. Some rolled on it, maybe out of aggression. But mostly, just go, go, go. Cast, cast, cast. Find those fish that want to eat. Let them tell you what they want. Then you're going to catch. It's like an element of surprise. They're swimming, doing their own thing. They're not too inquisitive to chase anything. The little KVD splash lands, woof, a triggering effect. Right away, come over and look at it. Looks like something to eat, and it does look in the water because I'm working it slow. It's that first cast. So cast out, work it a bit, nothing, bring it in, cast out, element of surprise. Look at that. I didn't even touch the bait. And it's a decent fish too. Boy, oh boy, oh boy. This way you just loosen back on that drag. Make sure it's pulling out. Bury the rod. Make sure that bait doesn't get caught under the boat. Look at him pull and drag. Look at that. Pull and drag. Again, look at just a nice fish. Beautiful smallmouth bass, man. Man, I love you creatures. You are a whole different breed, aren't you? A whole different breed than your largemouth friends, huh? And your largemouth cousins. It's all about the catching, not the size today. But when I can see fish jumping on my bait like that, catching them, what else do I need? Do I want to catch a giant? Sure, man. We all love big fish, don't we? But when they're like that, and they're chunky, they got big bellies, and they're cooperating, I just catch them and let them go. Now, I don't know how much longer I'm going to stay out here. You know, I've caught a bunch. It's probably, 8 o'clock in the morning, and I've caught at least 15 fish. Did I get any big, real, you know, really big guys? Not yet. That's not what it is. That's not what this is. It's using a new bait, KVD splash, putting it out, figuring out how they want it presented, catching those fish, and having fun. Man, this is a day I won't forget for a long time, but I want to get a big one. Let's go. You know, one of the best things about topwater is you don't have to have specialized equipment. I like doing it because it's my job. St. Croix topwater rod, you know, it's just got a little bit beefy section, but it's got that limber tip in midsection. When those fish pull by the boat, you're not pulling the little treble hooks out. You know, it's got enough backbone to get the hooks in, but doesn't pull them out when the fish gets close to the boat. That's the crucial spot about the length of this rod. When those fish are close to the boat, 6 feet, 7 feet, very important. There's not much line stretch. You're gonna rely on your rod and your reel. Otherwise, just another fish story. It does mean trouble. Look at that, he took it off the surface. Wow, he's in the weed. Oh boy, look at this thing. Look at him cut. Uh-oh. How big are you, huh? He took that off the surface. Amazing, huh? Yeah, man. Amazing, amazing fish. Oh, decent smallmouth too, look at that. Wow. I have to get my little net here too, huh? Oh! Oh! Is he meant to be caught or what? Do you believe that? Look at that mess. Look at that mess. Do you believe that, huh? One of the nicest fish of the day. I just casted. I said, see those weeds there? And look what he's in. You couldn't get a more picturesque fish, huh? Look at that. Right where he should be. Corner of the mouth. Got another hook there. Wow. What do you think he was hiding in this fish, huh? Or feeding in? Think he's in weeds? Look at that. That's a decent picture fish from the live well. He didn't even blow up. The bait just gets sucked under. You talk about non-aggressive. Look at his stomach still. Fat too. Ho ho. Put him in there. But when you're fishing topwaters, in the day could mean 9, 10 o'clock. But when you find this stuff, see that right there? This right here? You look at it and you say to yourself, well, it looks brown, looks old, looks burnt out. Cover for fish. That's all it is. Bait fish find it, you find it, fish find it, you catch them. Whew, let's go. What a morning. Brand new bait, KVD Splash. I didn't mean to splash. You know why? Those smallmouth saw it. They weren't very aggressive, but they still ate it. I had to boot around, find fish that wanted to eat, and with those big fat bellies, they were just sluggish. Come up, suck it down. So I had to go fast, but fish slow. Going fast, moving around, finding new fish, different pods of fish, working it, fishing it slow. A lot of times when this little bait hit the water, those fish just sucked it in. So you knew it landed pretty close to where he was. But those days of them coming up, bashing it, smashing it, and catching 20 in half an hour, wasn't today. But I still got the topwater bite. I still had fun. You can too when you learn to go fast and slow for smallmouth. Listen, thanks for watching. We'll see you guys next time right here on Extreme Angler TV. Let's go home. Daiichi, world's sharpest hooks. Snag Proof, a leader in weedless frogs. Gamma Fishing Lines. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com. Watch us, like us, follow us, see us.